Norman Hess wrote Damien as Romana Clay, a souvenir, a memento of his childhood and loss of innocence. He felt that it was the moment he became sexually active that marked his rite of passage from child to adult. Now, this week's assignment is to write about your first sexual experience. Yes, Ross?
First sexual experience, first kiss, first time.
First time you had intercourse.
What if you've never had intercourse?
I'm a virgin.
Nobody's a virgin.
You're so pretty.
You're a what?
Really?
What are you, like, paranoid about AIDS?
Do you prefer women?
Me too. You just haven't found the right guy.
I could be that guy.
Oh. Hey, you don't know what you're missing.
Great.
What is this?
It's my first sexual experience. Look, my first sexual experience has yet to occur. I've written what I can. I think I deserve an A.
This isn't like you.
It's very much like me.
I can't believe in this day and age you're still a virgin, Rachel.
Maybe I deserve an F.
I just can't take it anymore. They're all a bunch of idiots. I mean, I wish for once I could just meet someone who respected my choice. Bob, come on. I'm serious.
I respect you, Rachel. I do.
Are you saying that just to get me in the sack?
Don't flatter yourself. I'm saving myself, too.
Screw you.
Changed your mind that quick?
Actually, I did meet somebody. I think he might be different.
Really?
He lives across the street.
Convenient.
I really like him.
Great.
A study shows that 50% of all girls will lose their virginity before they reach college. Here at Carleton High, it's Sexual Awareness Week. Condoms, spermicidal jellies, and rubber dams are being handed out to students in an effort to prepare them for healthy, responsible, normal sexual lives.
I don't know who it was wrote it, or by whose pen it was signed. Someone once said, and I quote it, it's a woman's prerogative to change her mind. He may have you in a halter, harnessed before and behind, but till you that altar, it's a woman's prerogative to change her mind. Promise anything, anything.
I mean, look at this. I'm always wearing white whenever I eat spaghetti. There's nothing quite as attractive as a spaghetti stain on white.
Well, you know, it can be very sexy.
Yes, it can be, but you don't have to pay for the dry cleaning bill.
Hey, did you get a chance to develop that film we shot last week?
Not yet.
Why don't you come over to the house sometime this next week? I have nobody booked. We can use my dark room.
Great.
All right?
Yeah. Tips from the master.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. No, not so great. I make a good living and I have somewhat of a name. But if you would ask me, is this where I wanted to be 20 years ago? No.
I know exactly what you mean. That's my greatest fear, to wake up in 20 years with the same dreams I have right now.
You know where that comes from, that fear?
Where?
It all comes from a fear of never being intimate with someone. Dying before you ever really make love. Missing all those important experiences. You know what I mean? Do you remember that incredible relief you felt when you first really made love? Can I walk you upstairs?
No, that's okay. I can walk myself.
Okay.
I suppose I should give you this back. Thanks. Well, I had a great time tonight.
Me too.
Allergic to any medications?
No.
Have you ever had hepatitis?
No.
When was the last time you had sexual relations?
No.
Now let me rephrase that. When was the last time you had sex?
Never.
You've never had sex?
Make for me.
For you? Something endangered. How about a swan? Beautiful and proud.
Aw, what would I do without you, Bob?
You'd have fewer balloons.
Mm. Hi.
Hi. Got something for you. This one matches your hair.
You do that pretty well.
Mm. 4 years at Yale.
Here's my number. I'd love to see you sometime. Jesus. Look at that face. We are just as bad. Bad as bad. Well, what would you call it? I mean, whatever happened to hard to get, you know?
It's a good thing women aren't using their virtue as a commodity anymore. At least they've stopped playing games. They're more direct.
Wait a minute. Stop playing games. I think we're expected to be participants in the game, or, you know, we're not regarded as human beings anymore. It's like everywhere I look, I'm slapped in the face by product shots of people
fondling.
I mean, sex has become this bargaining chip, and if you're not going to say
ignore... Okay. Let me get back to work now.
Sorry. I'll look around a little. I'll be back.
Okay.
I'm having visions.
You're lucky.
I had this dream last night.
Sounds like this is gonna be brilliant.
No, I'd had this accident where I was hit by a car and I was in the emergency room and the doctor was asking me all these routine questions. And when I told him that I'd never had sex before, he completely freaked out. He was so shocked that he forgot to stabilize me and I died.
Jesus, Rachel, it sounds like you're ready to lose it already.
No.
Why don't you just get rid of the damn thing? Break that mucous membrane.
Bob, I mean, I don't understand. The whole point of this sexual revolution was supposed to liberate women. I mean, what's the point of the freedom of saying yes if you don't have the freedom to say no? I'm not allowed to say no. It makes me
afraid, repressed, diseased, anything but a true woman.
Just tell me something. How do you know if you've picked the right person if you've never slept with one? How will you know?
I'll know.
It's not good enough. I mean, what happens if you marry this person and on your wedding night you find that he just doesn't make it in bed?
That's impossible. If I love him, I'll love him in bed. And it's not about waiting for my wedding night. It's about, I don't know, it's about the feelings. If the feelings are there, then everything else is going to fall into place.
No sé, se me ocurrió de repente. ¿A tu edad es normal haber estado con una chica?
Y dale con la edad. Estoy harto de que todo el mundo me trate como un subnormal.
Bueno, está bien, retiro la pregunta, ¿no?
Me demostraré que no soy un maricón.
Oye, a mí no tienes que demostrarme nada.
Bueno, pues se lo voy a demostrar.
Ángel.
I saw your lie down. I hope you don't mind.
No, not at all. Come on in. So, what kind of tea do you want? We've got extraordinary Earl Grey, Lipton.
Whatever you're having is fine. Okay. You know, I brought these for you.
Oh, you did? I was wondering what those are.
Well, they're either a kumquat or a loquat.
A loquat?
Or kumquat.
Well, they're very unique. Thank you. There you are.
Thank you.
Want to go sit in the living room?
Would you play something?
No.
Come on.
No,
I heard you from across the street. You're very good. Please.
I can't.
For me, come on.
Okay. You know that guy I told you about?
Yeah.
Well, he wasn't the one.
How did you know?
The time came, but I didn't. No pun intended.
No pun received.
I love the ocean. There's something about it I can't explain.
There doesn't have to be an explanation.
I'm a virgin.
That's a shame. Too bad you couldn't explore a few things before you got this age. But maybe I can help you out a little bit, you know?
No. I mean, you're so pretty.
Get out of here.
Today?
I find that hard to believe.
I want to marry one, but I can't see dating one for long.
Are you ashamed of your body?
That's great. Yeah.
Are you... You know, you prefer women?
I'm sorry to hear about that.
Are you Catholic?
Are you sure? I mean, are you like, you know, born again?
I wish more women could say that.
You think it's dirty?
I'd be proud to make you a woman.
That's what brings you happiness.
I knew that.
No, you're lying. You're lying. I mean, how can that? I don't get it.